In its heyday, Coney Island prospered as a seaside resort for New Yorkers. But while some of the images remain, many others have changed. Today, Coney Island is home to one of the toughest sections of Brooklyn. It is also the place where the Marbury family dream was born. Stephon's three older brothers all showed great promise as they all tried to reach the NBA, but each of them would fall short. So when the fourth brother was born, the family's quest was renewed.
We always told Stephon, you will be a point guard, so you must keep the ball in your hand at all times. This is when he was 3 years old.
Growing up, my brother used to tell me, you're the person that's going to go to the top no matter what.
And so from an early age, Stephon was focused on basketball.
In the house, in the project, Stephon used to just always act like he's shooting the ball. He'd take a coat hanger and make him a basket, and he would shoot the ball.
My mom used to send me to the store. She'll look outside the window. She see me running up and down the court. She just starts screaming to the top of her voice, Stephon!
No matter where he went, he always took his basketball. The first thing you would hear was the ball.
This little round ball, my brother told me, it could take you all around the world. This ball right here could do so many things.
With his family providing constant guidance, Stephon learned not only about basketball, but also about some of the realities of life.
My brother Eric, he just embedded in my mind that these streets is mean. I had pressures just trying to survive in the ghetto, you know what I'm saying? Just trying to live every day. We used to walk around with two bags going, ice cold sodas and beer here. Ice cold sodas. So cold it buy your fur coat. We used to do that. That's how we made money.
Determined to create a better life, Stephon worked tirelessly on his game, and success soon followed. He became the first Marbury to win a city championship. Then at age 20, after just 1 year at Georgia Tech, he made the family's dream a reality.
Fourth pick in the 1996 NBA draft, Stephon Marbury from Georgia Tech University.
Every time I think about it, it makes me emotional. It was just, you know, we're here. We've been playing the game for like 24 years, chasing this dream, chasing this goal. And then finally, we had someone achieve the goal.
I can't even explain the way I feel right now. It's been 20 years. You waited for this day. It just feels so good. I can put a permanent smile on my mother's face.
Stephon would now head to Minnesota, where he would make an instant impact with the Timberwolves.
Marbury, a lane to the basket.
Oh! I'm about to turn it up, baby. No. 54 counter.
Here we go. They go to Marbury. In the air, Steph.
There you go. Oh, baby. That's why you have players like Steph on Marbury on your team.
But for all his success on the court, Marbury was anything but happy after leaving Coney Island behind. He missed it far more than he could ever imagine.
I love playing basketball there, but it was difficult for me living in Minnesota. To me, that was like something totally, totally different. Being in a place where I didn't have any family, you know, and I was basically there by myself.
Channeling all his energy into the game, he continued to grow as a player, but he never really felt at home.
When you're miserable and you're thinking about this and thinking about that, that's hard, man. You know, maybe that's why I really never really smile on the court. I always look unhappy. After we lost in the playoffs, I was on the next plane. I didn't pack any clothes. I took socks and underwear and left.
But after 2.5 years in Minnesota, Marbury would pack his bags once again when he was traded to the New Jersey Nets. No longer would he have to rush home at every opportunity. The kid from Coney Island was back on familiar ground.
When I got traded, man, it was like, it's too good to be true. I'll never forget when I first came back, this reporter, he said, you must really, really love where you come from. I said, man, only if you knew. I'm able to come here and fit right in like everybody else, and there's nothing. You know, they were saying me so much, like, yo, what you doing out here? I'm like, I live here. What you talking about? What am I doing out here? This is where I'm from. You know, I bring a lot of different things to the game, and you know what I can bring to Phoenix is just the will to win.
Now a perennial all-star, Stephon has found a home in Phoenix, where he's enjoying tremendous success as the leader of the Suns.